think are most effective in becoming elected, and we'll see where it goes.
John, what role does Senator Ted Cruz play in the Republican Party right now?
Well, he is the voice of the anger against the establishment of both parties, against Washington, D.C., against Obamacare. I have to say, the verb that was used there, who is Mitt Romney to disqualify anybody for anything? He ran the worst campaign in that, right? The worst.
Look, this is unbelievable. We care, but I thought NBC must have had a strategy meeting how to help Obama. Let's bring up the man Romney.
Wow!
You could have had as president. This man ran as the most incompetent presidential candidate with a chance to be elected president, running the worst campaign in history, and he's going to tell people what to do. He should do the exact opposite of what he says. Unbelievable.
A year ago, the day after tomorrow, he lost, and the Republican Party was a mess, right?
Still is a mess, John.
A year later, yeah, it's more of a mess.
You blame one person for that?
No, but he has said a lot of it. It's the establishment wing of the Republican Party, and he doesn't get it.
You know, it's interesting. I'm going to share now Nancy B. Crump on my Twitter page, because before our break, I asked people to weigh in on this. She says, anyone who leaves Ted Cruz off the list is off my list for anything. What's the problem with hard work and supporting the Constitution? The public's perception of him is that he's a fighter.
That's exactly right. And the government shutdown, which was unpopular and has hurt the Republican Party, inside the Republican Party, the primary voters, the activists, love Ted Cruz, which is a sign of what John and Pat were saying, the divisions which have really ripped the Republican Party asunder.
Well, and I want to bring Pat into this. You really can't get away from Ted Cruz when you consider the millions of Americans who might love to see his name on a presidential ballot. Can we take a look? I'm going to ask my team to put up some numbers here. This is a poll that was taken recently by the Wall Street Journal, and it shows how people identify and what party they would consider voting for in 2016. The numbers there are pretty close between Democrat and Republican, but the one that really stands out is that 30%, nearly a third of American citizens said, oh, you know what, we'll go with an independent or a third party.
In every poll that I have seen, including some work I've done recently, the number of people either picking an independent or saying they want someone other than the parties are getting is higher than we've ever seen. It's consistent, and it reflects the frustration. First, the Republicans and what happens in the shutdown. Now, this latest thing with Obamacare, where Obama is morphing into, I can't decide what he's morphing into, George H.W. Bush or worse, which is
Richard Nixon.
But this idea of the corruption and lying to the American people is just appalling to voters. And Democrat, our party, Doug, our party, Democrat, what do they do? They're getting up and saying, oh, by the way, don't look at what we did. We don't care. Anything to win. And that's where people are going. Who represents us?
Are we watching, Harris? I think this is significant. We're watching. We watched the Republican Party self-immolate with the shutdown. And those numbers you just put on, they're third now behind independents for who people would vote for.
It's close.
But they're third. Now we're watching the Democrats self-immolate. We're watching both major parties in this fall both kill themselves.
So who can stand up, Doug? Because you heard Pat just annihilating your own party, your Democrat party there. You didn't interrupt him. So
no, he's right.
So who can move forward now, looking in advance?
Right now, as we sit here, Harris, the high numbers for independents that you were citing are emblematic of the fact that there really is no one on the scene who is providing real leadership.
Not one name comes to mind.
I could say somebody like Chris Christie, but here's the real problem. President Obama's strategy is to double down with attacks on the Republicans, and as Pat and John have said, to shade the truth or just ignore the truth. The Republicans are just attacked. No agenda. Bottom line, the American people, incredibly angry.
Let's talk presidential credibility here if we can, because Pat, you mentioned before you were kind of comparing President Obama and hinting at his disapproval rating, I believe. So let's put those numbers up on the screen. This is a very recent poll that was taken in just the last week or so. And what it shows is that disapproval number has ticked up above 50% now. And continues to go north.
Well, the approval rating is the lowest in the Wall Street Journal poll that we've seen over the they've ever measured the ties of the lowest. But let me tell you something. I was the youngest person on Richard Nixon's list. Watching his president dissemble to the American people, whether it is on whether it's on Benghazi, whether it's on healthcare, getting up and telling people, knowing you're lying, as we now know from the reports, that they knew what they were doing. They couldn't have won the election without, they couldn't have passed on healthcare, but everything, the red line, I don't know anything, I know nothing, I'm not the sergeant, so everything. But I want to tell you, the corruption here is as great
Sergeant
as it was in the Richard Nixon.
It's been, I think what Pat is talking about is this line about if you like your insurance, you can keep your insurance.
You think that's really been damaging?
I think it's a turning point in this presidency.
Dickie is the perception problem for Democrats, for this president, I should say, among his own party. Because they're going to be facing election, re-election, some of them, a year from now. How sticky is this problem?
Let me speak to this as a Democrat. Everybody stayed together until recently on health care. There's been breakaway senators, as we talked about last week, on delaying the individual mandate, delaying the penalty. Now, when the White House has acknowledged they didn't tell the truth, you're going to see Democrats increasingly moving away from a president who for 5 years, 5.5 years, has had unquestioned loyalty.
What amazes me is the what some people are willing, women's willing to go off the cliff with him on this. Even Bill Maher, who said it, I thought, as much as I am on Bill Maher, said it on his show this weekend to Deborah Wasserman Schultz, the chairman of the Democratic Party, where she was making up this fantasy. He said, you know, I thought President Obama was honest. He's not, and neither are you. He just tore her apart. The problem for the Democrats are, who's going to go off the cliff with this, and who is going to start caring about their own survival.
All right, you mentioned Benghazi. There's been news made on that this weekend. We'll get into that after the commercial break. A new push for answers in the deadly Benghazi terror attack. A top senator is now calling for a witness who recently shared his story to testify before Congress. What do you think about it? You can tweet me your comments again at Harris Faulkner. Hashtag Fox Report Weekend. That's my favorite hashtag, by the way. Only second to the Fox News Insiders, I should say. Plus, four people hurt when a car plows into a convenience store. Then the woman gets out of the car. We'll toggle back to news with the rest of the story. Stay with us.
So, you say men are superior drivers?
Yeah.
Then how do I get this?
Safe driving bonus check. Every 6 months without an accident, Allstate sends a check. Silence. Are you in good hands?
You know how painful heartburn is. For fast, long-lasting relief, use doctor-recommended Gaviscon. Only Gaviscon forms a protective barrier that helps block stomach acid from splashing up, relieving the pain quickly. Try fast, long-lasting Gaviscon.
The Volkswagen Sign-In Drive sales event is back. Which means it's never been easier to get a new Passat. Awarded J.E. Power's most appealing mid-sized car 2 years in a row. And right now, you can drive one home for practically just your signature. Get zero due at signing, zero down, zero deposit, and zero first month's payment on any new 2014 Volkswagen. Hurry! This offer ends December 7th. For details, visit dwdealer.com today.
That is any garden country.
This story knows how to handle a Saturday ride. The parking lot helps by letting us know who's coming. The carts keep everyone on the right track. The power tools produce themselves. All the bits and bolts keep themselves stocked. And the doors even handle the checkout, so we can work on that thing that's stuck in the thing.
Today, Cisco is connecting the Internet of Everything, so everyone goes home happy.
At OB, whatever business you're in, that's the business we're in. With premium service, like one of the best on-time delivery records and a low claims ratio, we do whatever it takes to make your business our business. OD, helping the world keep promises.
I won this 55-inch TV for less than $30 on DealDash.com.
I got this $1,200 computer for $100.71.
These aren't actors. They're real people who got real savings at DealDash.com, the fair and honest bidding site.
On DealDash.